create a new document. I am choosing 1500 by 1500 pixels. Center it. Make sure you have only stroke and no fill selected. This is the design we are going to make, so we'll keep a sample of it on the side. This whole thing will be made after two shapes, so we'll make the shapes beforehand, this one and this one. To make the shapes, we'll make a circle. Only thing you need to remember is the square is actually half the circle. That will depend on the size of your design. So make a circle. I'm choosing 250 pixels. Then make a square by 125 pixels. So it's half the circle actually. Place the square so that it's exactly touching the edges and on the center. Now select both. Make sure the stroke is aligned to the inside and it's 1 point, and then choose the transform panel and hit merge. From the pathfinder section you can use the merge option and this will create the first option. Now to create the second pattern, we'll need one circle and two squares. Place the square like the first, like did in the first object, and the second square will be placed diagonally to the first one. Select both and hit unite. So you're going to get this. These two shapes will be the most important part. This will form the entire design. Now remember the size of the square, so it's 125. Center it. This is very important to center it because you can use the rotate option. If you want, you can lock it also. Now take a copy of this design and place it very carefully at the corner of the square in the middle. Zoom in to see that whether it is aligned properly. Make sure it's aligned properly. Now selecting this one, hit R on your keyboard and alt click in the center and give a 90 degree rotation and you'll get 4, and hit Ctrl D to repeat the option. So this is your inner part. Now make another square the same size obviously. Place it at the corner of this place. Now what we are going to do is again zoom in and make sure the points are touching. Use the anchors, it will help, not the path. What we are going to do is we are going to create all the designs on the first place and we are going to rotate it by 90 degrees. So we are going to use this and we are going to form the designs, one quarter of the design. Now make sure everything is aligned. Remember to hold it by the anchor, not on the path. So you will use this one 3 times on each of the corners of the square. Rotate it by holding shift and place it. Do this a third time. You may don't need to make a copy, you're just going to use this one. Rotate it by holding shift and by 90 degrees and align it to the edge of the remaining square. Make sure your alignment is proper. hitting Control 0, you go back to the previous view. Now we are going to select everything we just made except the other parts. So we need these three objects here. You have to press Shift on your keyboard to select it, including the middle square. Hit R on your keyboard and place the turning radius at the middle and rotate it by 90 degrees. So you get these, and hit Ctrl D to repeat it. So that's your design made. Now unlock everything. Now select everything and then holding Shift deselect the squares. Go to Object, Path and Offset Path. Turn the preview on. I'm using .35. Remember this number. Now select one of the squares, go to Select and Same and Shape. So it will select all the squares. Again go to Object, Path and Offset Path, and this time you just need to do the minus of that negative. You have to get to a negative point so that it will match properly. That's your basic design for now. We're not going to need this anymore, so delete it. We don't need the pathfinder, so remove that. Now select everything. Merging doesn't help, because you can see. Use the Shape Builder tool. Just enlarge the design you're going to make so that you can see it properly and visualize the as this is a Celtic design, so it's always over and under. Using the Shape Builder tool, we're going to do this. Now the thing happens, that is, it's going to miss some of the parts. We have to fill them up later. So keeping your eye on the design, make the over and under design as best as you can, and the lines missing will be later filled on. If you make a mistake, then hit Ctrl Z on your keyboard and it will just go back a step. You can see my key presses in the bottom left hand corner. Take your time while doing this. Make a mistake, you go back with Ctrl Z. Once you have made that, you will see that the small lines are missing. So what you need to do is you use the pen tool for that, and make sure you're using the pen tool from the anchor point, not at the intersection or the path. Make sure you always connect the anchors together so that it fills in. Control click outside to deselect and fill in the lines that are missing. Make sure to always connect by the anchor points and not on the path or intersection points. now that your basic design is made, we are going to fill it with color. We'll just lower the copy of the object design at the bottom. Now we are going to use the live paint option. If you get a warning, then you need to click OK. You can use either way of coloring. So I'm going to use the swatch panel actually. This color is completely up to you. This is the way I am choosing to do it. I'm going with the red, blue, green and yellow option. You can choose whatever color you want. You can even use the gradient option in this. Now that it's colored, we'll select everything and increase the stroke weight so that the stroke of the object is a bit visible a bit more. So select everything and increase the stroke weight. I'm going to increase it to 5, so you can see a black outline. Now if you want, you can put, I'm going to put a background behind it, so make this, make a square, fill it with color, make a color that is contrasting to the design. So check which color you want. You can actually put a gradient also, but I am choosing one here. After you finalize the background, you don't need this anymore. Right click on it, go to range and move to send to back, then center the background. And that's your basic design. You can choose all the colors, you can change every single color here. Thank you.